Lava and pyroclastic flows can burn vegetation close to the eruption center. The shockwave of a large volcanic eruption can flatten trees many kilometers from the main vent. For example, in the 2nd century AD, the violent eruption of the Lake Taupo caldera flattened and buried forests west of Lake Taupo. The remnants of these forests can be found here, west of the lake, in the buried forest in the Puriora Forest Park. These forests were preserved by the processes of being buried. They were accidentally uncovered by a digger in 1983. There is plenty of evidence of here of the ash and pumice that rained down on this area. For example, we've got this piece of pumice here. There's plenty of pumice in the soil.
Pyroclastic flows from Taupo burnt the forests south of the eruption center and covered them with ash. Today, only the toughest plants can survive in the area which is known as the Rangipo Desert. Lava flows can also interrupt the normal patterns of vegetation succession processes. This is evident in many parts of the Tongariro National Park. Volcanic eruptions can influence drainage patterns. In the short term, lahars can flow into rivers, temporarily raising the water level. More dramatic permanent changes can also occur. Sometimes, an explosion crater will fill with water to form a lake. For example, the Tama lakes are two crater lakes in New Zealand's Tongariro National Park. They fill explosion craters on the Tama saddle between Mount Ruapehu and Mount Narahoe. Debris from volcanic eruptions can block rivers, causing them to be diverted. The Waikato River used to flow out into the Firth of Thames, but was diverted westwards by an ancient volcanic eruption. Existing lakes can expand even larger as a result of volcanic debris blocking water outlets. For example, Lake Rotomahana to the southwest of Mount Tarawera grew substantially in size after the 1886 eruption. Before the eruption, the lake was about 2 kilometers long by 1 kilometer wide. The eruption opened up a long rift that passed through the lake. The lake water came into contact with the magma below, causing an enormous explosion that caused the surrounding area to be covered with ash and mud. The world-famous pink and white terraces were destroyed in the eruption, as were several Maori villages, such as Te Wairua, also known as the Buried Village. The lake eventually refilled with water and is today 6.2 kilometers long and 2.8 kilometers wide. Volcanic ash is rich in many elements required by plants. Thus, areas receiving volcanic ash will often enjoy an increase in soil fertility due to minerals such as sulfur being added to the soil. All around the world, people have settled near volcanoes because of the fertile soil surrounding them. For example, in the Franklin district south of Auckland, settlements such as Bombay and Pukekohe enjoy fertile volcanic soils and are known for their market gardens. From the Pukaki crater in Mangere to Pukekawa in the Waikato region, there are numerous ancient weathered volcanoes that have contributed to the soils of this region. On the other hand, large amounts of volcanic ash can result in soils that have a cobalt deficiency, which causes a disease in farm animals. Cobalt is needed by nitrogen-fixing bacteria and by grazing animals. The soils of the volcanic plateau in the central North Island have this deficiency due to two major eruptions in this region, Taupo, around 200 AD, and Kaharoa, about 1314 AD, which deposited layers of cobalt-deficient ash. there is a clear link between historic eruptions being followed by years of colder global climatic conditions. The 1991 eruption of Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines caused a plume of sulfur dioxide to spread around the globe. Global temperatures decreased by 1 degree over the following 2 years. In 1815, the eruption of Mount Tambora in Indonesia resulted in an extremely cold spring and summer in 1816. This has become known as the year without a summer. Snowfalls in the summer months destroyed crops and livestock in Europe. People went hungry. During this time, glaciers advanced.